we fix the camera just to tilt up a little bit? There we go. Oh, sorry guys, the camera's not cooperating today. Are we crooked a little bit? There we go. No, Lisa, but bring it down on the side a little bit. There. Hold on, guys. We're trying to adjust the camera for better viewership. There we go. We got it. Okay. So welcome, everyone, to Healthy Cooking with Shayda. I'm your host, and this is where I teach you all about plant-based cooking that's salt, oil, and sugar-free. Today, unfortunately, Erin is not with us because she is out sick. She's not feeling well. So I've got my dear friend Lisa here. Let's all welcome Lisa to the show. Hi, sweetheart. Hi. Nice to have you.
It's nice to be here.
Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you for coming in last minute. Mm-hmm. I really, really, truly appreciate mm-hmm. it. Guys, today you're in for a treat. We're going to be making a Mediterranean chickpea salad with a zesty pomegranate dressing. And you all know how much I love my pomegranates. But before we get started, if you haven't subscribed already to our YouTube channel, please make sure to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you like our video. And one other thing, you guys, please make sure you comment on the video. I really enjoy getting all your feedback and answering your questions on Facebook. And that's where I'll go in and I'll see your questions and I'll be more than happy to answer. So for today, should you have any questions, I'm trying to make this as easy as possible for Lisa because, you know, she's never been with us during a live. And so if you guys get any questions, make sure you start it with three question marks, ask your question, and then end it with three question marks. That'll help because the feed goes by pretty quickly, and that'll help Lisa to catch your questions and to, you know, ask me the questions that you're asking and for me to answer. So with all of that, let's get started. Like I said, we are making a Mediterranean chickpea salad, and obviously the star of the show are the chickpeas. So I've got them here that are rinsed and drained already, so it's ready to go. And then what I'm putting inside of it is going to be really things that I like. It will have the Mediterranean flavor because of the fresh cilantro and the fresh dill. Now, if there's some things you don't like, you don't have to do it. I've also gone ahead and chopped up, because again, my salads, I want them to be colorful. I've got one orange and one red bell pepper that we're going to add to this. And already, as you can see, this is starting to become very colorful. Next, we're going to add some chopped up green onions to this. Now, even at home when I'm not filming in front of you guys and I'm just cooking for myself, I make this mise en place here that I've got where everything's already, I'll chop everything up ahead of time. So that way when I'm cooking, I just have to add things either to the pot or to the bowl because it just makes cooking that much easier for me to do. The other thing we're gonna add is heirloom tomatoes. Now these cherry tomatoes, look, these are pretty big for me. And I don't really care for these, you know, somebody throwing a big cherry tomato like this in here. So I will slice it in half. And if it needs, if I can, I'll slice it again in half. And I'm just gonna chop those up and throw them in here. And you all know that I like things that are cut in uniform, but that doesn't mean that you guys have to cut them in uniform. You can cut them however you like, but just, you want to make sure that they're bite size and, you know, you don't want to get a big tomato in your mouth and go, oh my God, how the heck am I going to chew this up? Right? Do you cut your, would you throw in your cherry tomatoes like this
no,
in there?
No, absolutely not.
Okay, so it's not just me.
It's got to be cut at least once, maybe twice.
But some of them, like look at this one. This one is so big that, you know, you kind of have to chop it in half and then half that half again. And it just makes it, well, actually makes your salad pretty. And then you can eat it nicely instead of having these big pieces in here. So any thoughts or comments?
Not so far.
Not so far. You guys are being, so where is everybody watching from? I'd love to know where you guys are watching from. especially those of you that are out of the country, and I really appreciate your support. Some of you guys do tell me where you're watching from, so let's see if anybody will comment tonight where they are watching the YouTube live from. Nothing yet?
No, unless I'm not. It should show up, right?
Yeah, it'll be, they'll be posting it in the chat box. So, I don't know where you guys are at, but we're having a heat wave here, and it is not pretty. It is really, really hot. So, once you've got your tomatoes chopped up in there, we're just going to do a few more.
Okay, here's Janice. She's from Cedarburg, Wisconsin.
Hi! I've never been to Wisconsin. How's the weather in Wisconsin? Is it hot and miserable like it is here? Oy vey, it's pretty hot here.
Susan in Maryland, right outside DC.
Hi, Susan! Welcome! Okay, so we're going to give this a good toss. And then I'm going to show you guys that this salad can be really eaten several different ways. You don't have to eat it. I mean, you could eat it just like this. So the next thing we're going to add in here is I get these kosher baby dills from Costco, but pickles. I don't know about you, but there's just something about pickles in a salad that's really delicious. And if you, yes, there's probably salt in here. And if you want, you can rinse it. I typically don't. I typically don't just because I'm always running low on sodium. I wonder how much the sodium is. Yeah, I think we should rinse these, honestly, if you ask me. But now these we're gonna chop up. And these you wanna chop them up a little bit finer than the others. But if you haven't put pickles in your salads, it's really delicious. Do you like pickles?
I do, and I just put it in a salad for the first time this week.
And what did you think?
It was good. I was surprised.
It changes the, you know, I like pickles, and I like pickled jalapenos.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
Pickled jalapenos, you guys, if you haven't tried it, I know in some of my recipes I do add them. And they are absolutely delicious. And as I've always said, the measurements, especially when it comes to a salad, you don't have to measure everything. I give you measurements as just a roadmap. That's all it is. You know, if I've got half a cup of pickles in there and you want to put 3/4, then by all means, do 3/4. There's no right or wrong in this. At least that's how I feel, mm-hmm. You know, because some people may want more, some people may want less, some people may not want to put bell peppers, some people may want to add zucchini to this. Well, add zucchini to this, all right? That's what's fun about cooking. You can try different things, you know, and then you'll be surprised at some of the stuff you can create. Some of my best recipes came out of just whatever that was in the refrigerator, and I just decided to toss together, and then I'm like, oh, what did I do?
Yeah.
You know, and that's the other problem.
So, how can I recreate this?
How can I recreate this? Exactly. You're exactly right. Like, if it was pomegranate season, you all know that pomegranates would be in this salad, right? Like, there'd be no two ways about it, just because I put pomegranates in just about everything. So, all right, we got that in here. Like I said, the star of this show is the garbanzo beans, hence it's called a Mediterranean chickpea salad. So that's what we have so far. Look how colorful that is.
Beautiful.
Right? Mm-hmm. So now we are going to add some cilantro. We're also going to add some fresh dill. Do you like fresh dill?
I love it.
Yeah, you better say you love it, because you're married to a Persian guy. We eat a lot of dill. But I know there's people that don't like cilantro. And for those of you that don't like cilantro, you could put basil in here. You could put parsley in here. Don't think that it has to be cilantro. And I get it. There's people that really cannot have cilantro. It tastes like soap to them. Mm-hmm. And I'm so glad that's not me.
Me too.
Right?
I love it.
Yeah, and I tend to put cilantro in just about everything. But I just love having herbs in a salad. And I've always told you guys, keep putting herbs in your salad. It really, you know, I was talking to Glenn, you know, as you guys know, I'm writing my book, and the book's going to be coming out pretty soon. I'm co-authoring it with Dr. Gustavo Tolosa, and in one of the paragraphs, I talk about, well, you'll relate to this because, you know, Eric is Persian, but whenever you go to a Middle Easterner's house, and growing up, it was like this. During lunch or for dinner, we always had a bowl like this big of fresh herbs. It was mint, it was parsley, it was cilantro, it was chives, it was this, it was that, but we always had it on the table. Mm-hmm. So I remember Glenn was asking me, did you guys really eat that much fresh? I'm like, yeah, it was always on the table. You go to any Iranian's house even now.
Right, my mother-in-law does it.
See, there you
it's
go.
It's always there.
It's always there. So we're, you know, we're brought up with eating a lot of fresh herbs, and I absolutely love it. So make sure you're adding that in, and you put in as much as you like. There is no, it's really, when I was doing this recipe, it was the first time I made it, I'm like, oh my God, this is so good. But then I had to go and measure stuff out for you guys, and I gotta tell you, it was really hard to measure out the fresh dill portion of it, because I don't measure anything when it comes to the fresh herbs. I just chop it up and toss it in.
Susan loves the cilantro and dill, but she's not crazy about dill pickles.
No? Well, then you don't have to put it in. You know what you could put, Susan, in there? You could put cucumbers in there. You could put, but I wouldn't do the regular big cucumbers. I would do like either the Persian cucumbers, or I would do the English cucumber. Mm-hmm. I would put cucumbers in there. And if she does, yeah, because she doesn't like the pickle portion of it, so why add that in there? See, I haven't even added a dressing to this, and this already smells
wow.
good. Because you can smell the herbs.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Right.
So now we are going to, now different ways. Now this salad is ready to go the way it is. We're going to add the dressing. I'm going to make the dressing in front of you guys so you guys can see. I'm making a zesty pomegranate dressing so you guys can see how that's done. And then if you don't want to go through the hassle of making the, oh, can you hand me the, because I don't remember my own recipe for the dressing. There it is. Boy, it's, like I told you guys, it's really hot. when I tell you it's hot in here. Anyway, so the pomegranate dressing is super easy to make. There are a few things that you will need. First of all, I don't know about you guys, but I love my little Tri-Best blender. Why do I love it? Because I'm going to be making just a small amount, and here's the blade for it. We're going to put everything in here, and then we're going to lock the lid, flip it over, and call it a day. So when you purchase this machine, it comes in two of these sizes and two in a smaller size. So it's a great blender for making small amounts of dressings or small amount of sauces or whatever. Because yes, I could make it in my Vitamix, but seriously, for a small amount of dressing, would I do it in the Vitamix or would I do it in the Tri-Best? The Tri-Best mm-hmm. would be the better choice to go. Mm-hmm. I originally saw Kathy Fisher using this at True North. This is years ago when I used to go, and I thought, what a great idea. And it's been a real godsend to use this. So if you guys are interested in this, it's on my Amazon page. If you go to my Healthy Cooking with Shayda Amazon is my affiliate page, and it is there. So for this dressing, because it is called Zesty Pomegranate Dressing, we are going to be putting in pomegranate molasses. So let's talk about pomegranate molasses. It is absolutely delicious. But what you see in the Middle Eastern stores, and if you are going to, if you can't find this, which I'm going to put a link to this in the show notes for my Amazon page, you can find pomegranate molasses in any Middle Eastern stores, right? And there are different brands within the Middle Eastern stores. The best brand that I have found as far as taste is concerned, it's a brand called Cortaz, C-O-R-T-A-S. That happens to be one of the better ones as far as flavor. Because what you want is something that's a little bit sweet and sour. That's what you're looking for. The only problem is when you're buying it from the Middle Eastern store, is they add sugar to it. Now, if you're okay with that, then I would say then, okay, fine. But I was able to find this online on Amazon. It's by Al Wadi, pomegranate molasses, 100% natural, no added sugar. So I thought that was really great. Mm-hmm. And so is it a little bit more expensive? Yes, but at least you know you're getting the pure pomegranate molasses. In a pinch, would I use the regular, the one from the Middle Eastern store? Probably, because I'd have to wait about a day or two for this to come in. And if I'm making something last minute and I don't have any, I could just run to the Middle Eastern store, buy it and come home, and it saves the day. So even though we're only using like 3 tablespoons, again, it's your call, but you're welcome to go to my Amazon page and order it. It's a lot, I think it's a lot healthier. Do you use pomegranate molasses?
I do.
There you go. Which brand?
I don't remember. I think I have 2 in my cupboard, and I don't think they have sugar in them. Because I really try to buy things without sugar.
Yeah, I just had a hard time.
But I know you need to. They sneak it in.
They sneak it in. It's like date paste. You can find date paste in the Middle Eastern stores, but guess what? They add sugar.
Wow.
So again, you have to go and read it and find the ones that don't have the sugar in there. And I've never been able to find in the Middle Eastern stores pomegranate molasses that did not have sugar in there. At least I know the brand that I really like, the Cortaz that I was mentioned,
because
that has sugar in there. And it may not have a lot. Like I said, I've used it. Mm-hmm. Because in a pinch, if you think I'm going to wait for this and not finish the recipe, no. I'm going to go and get that. But in a pinch, yeah, I would do that. Next, we are going to use lime juice. Now, you guys all know I love lime, and I juice this ahead of time. I always save some with the zest, but that way, whenever I need lime, fresh lime juice, we always have it. I don't buy the ones that are in the bottle that are already pre-juiced and pre-done, because there's nothing like fresh. That we always have. Next, we are going to use sherry vinegar. So I buy this from Napa Valley Grand Reserve. I've always liked their product. As you can see, I like their balsamic vinegar. And in fact, that's the other thing I'm going to tell you. If you don't want to go through the trouble of making this dressing, which you don't have to, you can simply to this salad add balsamic vinegar, the Napa Valley, and take some fresh lime juice and mix it, and it's delicious. Mm. It's delicious. But I always like to give you guys an option. If it's something fun with a new dressing, why not? We're gonna add that in here. And then we're going to add some dried shallot. Now this, I get it from Penzies. Penzies is online, but you don't have to get it from Penzies. You can get dried shallot from anywhere that you like. You could even add fresh shallot in here. If you're gonna use fresh, just make sure it's a small shallot, not a lot. We're also gonna use Dijon mustard.
Linda's watching from Canada.
Oh, wow, that's
near
awesome.
Near Toronto, Ontario.
That's awesome.
So we got that.
that in there. What else do we have going on in here? Then we've got hemp seeds. So I buy this from Trader Joe's. It's the organic hemp seeds. We're gonna add some hemp seeds to this. And the recipes, you guys, it's all on my website at healthycookingwithshayda.com. So the recipes are there. And then let's not forget my favorite seasoning in the whole world. And you guys should know the answer if I ask you, what's my favorite seasoning?
Sumac.
There you go. She said it correctly. It's sumac. It's got this tangy, sour flavor that's just like, oh my God, it's so good. You guys will laugh. So I have this big bottle like this, but I also have, don't laugh at me, as a reserve, I have another big bottle.
Wow.
So yeah, we go through so much, a lot in this house. What can I do? So we're gonna add some of in here.
Linda has never used shallots before.
Oh, you're gonna be in for a nice surprise. Shallots are really, really good. And then we need some water. Let's add the water in here. Okay. And we're gonna close the lid. I mean, how easy is this? Yeah. Seriously. It doesn't get any easier. All right, let's taste it.
Cammie says the dressing sounds delicious. It's so hot here. We are eating salads every day.
Who's that?
Tammy. Oh, Tammy nice. Price.
Tammy, I hear you. Okay, so this dressing is a little tangy, and that's because I tend to lean more towards the sour stuff. Do you want to taste it a little bit
sure.
of it? I think Lisa should try it because
I like sour too.
She's never but you've never had this dressing,
no.
So it'll be good for you to.
That's good.
Mm-hmm. Is it good? Do you
yeah,
like
it is
it?
Good.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Very good.
So it's tangy.
It's just right.
Huh?
It's just right.
Yeah.
It is tangy.
It is tangy. All right. So then we're going to pour some on here. And then you're going to mix everything up. And I would do this probably about 30 minutes before you're ready to serve, because I think salads taste better when they're a little bit cold and the dressing's gone inside and it's kind of marinated itself. So that's really it for the salad, right? Look how pretty that is. Now, what are some other things that you could do with this salad? So the first time I made this salad, my mom's like, you know, it's really good, but it has too many chickpeas in here. And I said, well, considering it's a chickpea salad, that's what it's supposed to be. She goes, I know, but it's just like too many chickpeas for me. So I said, okay. So for her, what I did is I'm going to share it with you guys. If you guys want to do this, if you find that this is too many chickpeas in here, I took some romaine lettuce and I chopped up the romaine lettuce and I tossed it in there. And it added bulk to it, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then I took, one time I made, I had some quinoa left over, plain quinoa.
Mm-hmm.
So I added the plain quinoa with the romaine and I mixed all that together. And she goes, oh my God, you made a new salad. I said, oh my God, no I didn't. It's the same salad. It's just, I just added something else to it.
Mm-hmm.
And then I also added, we had a half of an avocado. So I chopped up some avocado in there. So that's another thing. You can add avocado to this and it's just gonna, you know, take it up a level. And then brown rice.
Mm-hmm.
If you've got, like, I know Trader Joe's sells those organic brown rice in the freezer. Mm-hmm. So if you want, you could warm up some brown rice and throw that in here as well. So there are many options that you could do with this salad to vary it up a little bit. So really, it's up to you, however you're going to like it. But the idea was I just wanted a protein-packed chickpea salad. But like I said, mom's like, okay, there's way too many chickpeas in here. So that's where we're at. And any thoughts, any questions from anybody?
Well, Angela from, she says hello from South Beach, and that she could dive into the salad bowl. It looks fabulous.
Oh, yes, Angela. It is absolutely delicious, and it's really hearty. I think it would be fun to have a pita bread. But I mean, if you want some and put it in a wrap, I mean,
yeah.
I just think with this, there's a lot of options that you can do to it.
Definitely.
You know, so it's whatever you like, and that's what I wanted. I wanted something that's going to be versatile for you guys. You could have it this way, you could have it that way, and that's what all this food and salad's all about. Just try it out, mix it up. Mm-hmm. You know, start experimenting. Mm-hmm. So any other.
No.
Anything else, guys, before we say goodbye?
And then Angela says, great meal post weightlifting session.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, post, okay.
Post working out, absolutely. She's absolutely. Well, Angela is our stud muffin who trains everybody. So, so yeah, she's absolutely right. This would be a great post-workout dinner, lunch, whatever you, breakfast. It's all good.
Sure.
But it's got all the Mediterranean flavors in there with the sumac and the pomegranates. Oh, and if you want, you can add some black pepper to this, which I have it here, and I completely forgot. So we can add a little bit of black pepper. And mix it up again. And that's it.
Tammy says, thanks so much.
Oh, you're welcome. And I want to thank you guys for watching another episode of Healthy Cooking with Shayda. We're going to try and do more live stream videos for you guys because you guys have been asking for it. And remember, guys, it's one bite at a time, one meal at a time. Stay cool and eat healthy. And I'll see you guys soon. Bye, guys. Have a good night.